Okay, hello zusammen. This is a video that should help you to understand how to get an A star in your writing controlled assessment in German. The writing controlled assessment makes up 15% of your final GCSE grade, so it is important that you pay extra attention to this video. So the first thing that you're going to get is the task prior to your controlled assessment. Really have a look at the task carefully, because it will give you hints as to which tense to use, as to what information you must include. What I want you to do is have a look at the task, take a moment, maybe pause the video, have a moment and think about what are the keywords in this specific task. So this task is about writing a blog about your area and the environment. You must include information about the area where you live, what the environmental problems in your area are, what the positive attractions of your area are, what you personally have already done to help, a description of your ideal town, and how your area compares to another one that you have visited. So keywords could be about the area. Information about the area needs to be in the present tense, so only talk about your area and what information you could give. Also, environmental problems in your area, again, this is going to be in the present tense. Positive attractions of your area, keep in mind your information does not have to be true. You can make anything up in your controlled assessment. So if you do not know what your positive attractions of your area could be, then just make them up. What you have personally already done to help. Now this is going to be in the past tense. It says what you have already done. So you need to write in the past tense. The description of your ideal town will tell you this needs to be in the conditional tense, and you need to compare your area to another one that you have visited. So think of conjunctions for comparisons, and also talk in the past or write in the past tense, but again you could link it to another tense there as well. But think about conjunctions that you could use to compare something. Also, prior to your controlled assessment, you get the chance to use a task planning form. I'd encourage you to really make the most of this task planning form, because even though you're allowed to use a dictionary, this will help you to remind you of the structure of your controlled assessment, of the plan that you've prepared prior to your writing controlled assessment. So you are not allowed to use conjugated verbs. This means no verbs with verb endings, no verbs in different tenses. But you're allowed to use verbs in the infinitive form. So this person here has used nouns like Verkehr, Woche, adjectives, sichtbar, angenehm, but also infinitives like verschmutzen and anbringen. So really make the most of your 40 word sheet. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to read out the piece of work of this candidate. Now there may be some mistakes in there because it's simply the work of the student that the student has written, but we're going to look at the criteria afterwards. In meiner Stadt gibt es immer viel Verkehr und es ist so gut wie unmöglich, einen Parkplatz in der Innenstadt zu finden. Letzte Woche war ich in der Stadt mit meiner Mutter, um ein bisschen einzukaufen, weil ich ein neues Hemd brauchte. Als wir ankamen, fuhren wir an drei vollen Parkplätzen vorbei. Ich war sichtbar verärgert, weil wir schon viel Zeit verbracht hatten. Mich beunruhigt, weil zu viele Autos die Luft verschmutzen könnte. Meine Stadt ist ziemlich umweltfeindlich, weil wir in der Nähe von einem Kraftwerk wohnen, welcher produziert viel Kohlendioxid. Viele Leute protestieren gegen die Umweltverschmutzung, sonst wird es zu spät sein. Es gibt auch viel Müll auf den Straßen und es ist überhaupt nicht angenehm. Meiner Meinung nach ist die Stadt ziemlich schmutzig. Andererseits hat der Bürgermeister gesagt, dass er mehr Radwege auf der Hauptstraße anbringen wird, weil wir wissen noch nicht, wann das sein wird. Es gibt immer etwas zu tun in meiner Stadt. Zum Beispiel, man kann in Kino oder zum Park gehen. Der Park ist wirklich schön im Sommer und alles gehen da oft, um Fußball zu spielen oder herumzulungern. Es gibt viele Geschäfte und Restaurants in der Stadt, samt das Geschäft, das mein Vater, wo man einkaufen kann. Es wird bald ein modernes Schwimmbad und eine neue Bibliothek geben. Ich habe schon viel für die Umwelt gemacht, beispielsweise habe ich ein paar Energiesparlampen gekauft, weil einerseits sie sehr gut für die Umwelt sind, aber andererseits machen sie nicht so viel Licht. Wenn ich einen Raum verlasse, mache ich das Licht auch und ich spare immer Wasser. Schließlich fahre ich normalerweise mit dem Rad oder mit dem Bus anstatt mit dem Auto. Meine Traumstadt wäre sehr schön, weil es am Meer liegen würde und es wäre immer sonnig. Der Bus würde jeden Uhr immer pünktlich kommen und es wäre keine Beschmutzung, weil alles recyceln würden. Es gäbe einen großen Park, wo man laufen könnte und es gäbe genug Radwegen in der Stadt. Letztens habe ich Dresden besichtigt und ich fand es prima. Leider gibt es mehr Geschäften in meiner Stadt, aber es gab viel mehr alten Gebäuden in Dresden. Es gab auch viele schöne Kirchen in der Innenstadt, obwohl es gibt mehr Waldland in meiner Stadt. Okay, so what made this an outstanding piece of work? Let's have a look at the criteria. So one of the aspects that you'd be graded on is going to be the content. Maximum marks you can get for content is 15. If we look at the grade boundary 10 to 12, which is good, it needs to be mostly relevant, responds to the task and shows ability to convey a lot of information clearly, express and explain ideas and points of view. To get the top marks, your answer needs to be fully relevant and detailed to the task. Sound ability to convey information clearly, express and explain ideas and points of view, and you need to have a well-organized structure. So really, to get the full marks, it needs to be fully relevant, so you must not write about anything else that may not be relevant to the task. So really make sure that you hit the nail on that, that you get to the point straight there. So AQA has awarded this candidate 15 out of 15. Now why is this? Let's have a look at some examples from the piece of work. So AQA has commented on the different dimensions of my area that had been explored, including environment, comparing and contrasting, and imagining. So if you read through the passage below, it's talking about the city that is environmentally, is not environmentally friendly because they live close to a power station, loads of people protest, and also there's lots of rubbish on the road, and also they're talking about their own opinion. So meiner Meinung nach ist die Stadt ziemlich schmutzig. So according to myself, in my opinion, the city is very dirty. And then she's talking about, but on the other hand, the mayor has said that he's going to make some improvements. So really, really develop answer there. And it's really exploring the different dimensions there, including the environment, including suggestions for improvements. Also, AQA has commented on the amount of detail that the candidate has used. So if you have a look at the example right here, it says that I have done a lot for the environment already. For example, I have bought a pair of energy-saving light bulbs because they are good for the environment, but also they do not give as much light as others do, that she switches off the light when she leaves the room. So really, really developed answer there with a lot of information. So she doesn't only say that she's using energy-saving light bulbs, she's really giving examples as to when she's using it, what are the advantages and disadvantages for this. And also AQA has commented on the ideas and points of view clearly expressed and developed. So if you look at the last example here, it's talking about the ideal town. That the ideal town would be close to the sea, would always be sunny. Now, again, she hasn't only written that it should be close to the sea, it should only be sunny. She talked about the bus, she talked about a huge park, she's talking about ways where you can cycle. So really, really giving more views and more developed answers there. Now, this is only about the content, because even though in those examples there may be some mistakes of accuracy, this is only about the content, and this is what AQA has commented on. Another example, aspect that you'll be graded on is going to be the range of language. This is going to be out of 10. To get the highest marks, you need to have a wide variety of appropriate vocabulary and structures. More complex sentences are handled with confidence, and verb tenses are used successfully. So you must make sure that more complex sentences are used, that you are using them with confidence. It does not mean that you're not allowed to get any mistakes in there, but the majority of it should be accurate, and verb tenses must be accurate for to get the top marks. AQA has awarded 10 out of 10 for this specific candidate. Now, why is this? Let's have a look. So One example is, ich war sichtbar verärgert, weil wir schon viel Zeit verbracht hatten. So the person is using the imperfect tense, ich war sichtbar verärgert, and the pluperfect tense, wir verbracht hatten, wir schon viel Zeit verbracht hatten. Also, the person is using more complex sentences with a variety of conjunctions that are joined together and the future tense. So, andererseits, das aber, there are three conjunctions in only one sentence. And it's also using the present, the future tense here, wann das sein wird, perfect tense hat gesagt. So, the perfect and the future tense in this. Also, it's used the perfect tense in the third example, ich habe schon viel für die Umwelt gemacht, perfect tense here, and again, loads of conjunctions combined in one sentence, weil einerseits, aber andererseits. So really make sure that you join conjunctions together to make up a more complex sentence. Meine Traumstadt wäre sehr schön, weil es am Meer liegen würde und es wäre immer sonnig. As I said at the beginning of this video, it said if it's talking about or you need to write about description of your ideal town, you need to use the conditional tense. And so this is what the candidate has done. Wäre, liegen würde and wäre again. This is the conditional tense. And der Park ist wirklich schön im Sommer und alles gehen da oft, Fußball zu spielen oder herumzulungern. So even though there's a spelling mistake here, the person has used the present tense and infinitive structures using zu, in order to. So if you use zu, which means in order to, you must use the infinitive afterwards, which the person has used successfully here. And the last criteria that you're going to be graded on is the accuracy out of 5. So your piece of work needs to be largely accurate if you want to get the full marks. There may still be some errors, especially in attempts at more complex sentences. Verb and tense formations are secure. So as I previously said, if you use complex sentences, there could be some errors, but verb and tenses, they need to be very, very accurate. So AQA is awarded 5 out of 5 for this candidate. Let's have a look. They said that occasional minor errors occur, but overall, the journalist was very, very accurate in this piece of work. I have outlined some minor errors that the person has done. This is just an example. There may be some others still in the piece of work. So, for example, der Park ist wirklich schön im Sommer und alle gehen dahin. I've corrected the mistake already. So, ist is supposed to be the correct word. So, spelling was the mistake here. Im, the person has used in, it's going to be im, it was the wrong preposition, and they've used the wrong word, so I've corrected them, und alle gehen dahin. The wrong gender was used, it's der Bürgermeister, it's masculine. So, andererseits hat der Bürgermeister gesagt. Wrong case used, so it's supposed to be the dative in here, because it's von, weil wir in der Nähe von einem Kraftwerk wohnen, welches viel Kohlendioxid produziert. So the spelling was wrong there. And the word order. So if you use welches, the verb will always have to go at the end. It's similar for obwohl, although, and weil, which means because. And the last example is, leider gibt es mehr Geschäfte in meiner Stadt, aber es gab viel mehr alte Gebäude in Dresden. Look at the plural forms. The person has written Geschäften, I think. This is Geschäfte, Gebäude. These are all the corrected mistakes already on this page right here. Last but not least, all I can say is viel Erfolg and good luck for your controlled assessments. I'll keep my fingers crossed for you.